the belt of truth, the helmet of salvation, and the sword of the spirit.
And be generous to your teacher. Joking. Let's pray. Dear Lord, thank you for today. Teach us your word. We want to know more about you. May your word stay in our hearts. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Children, remember, God is in control.
He's got the whole world in His hands. He's got the whole world in His hands. He's got the whole world in His hands. He's got the whole world in His hands.
Sing it, kids.
Yeah.
You are a healer indeed.
Is hurting, when life is so confusing, I am sure of one thing, guided by my side, yeah. When I'm feeling lonely, and I start to worry, I know God, you're near me, and you're always by my side, yeah. And I can lift my hands up to you. I can raise my voice and sing. You are who I put all hope in. I will trust you in everything.
Hope. When we worry, when we are afraid, you are our hope. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for being with us. You never leave us nor forsake us. You always love us and you cover us with protection and with provision. We thank you for peace or shalom that comes from our Heavenly Father. In Jesus' name, we give thanks and all God's children say, Amen. And amen.
Hey kids, have you ever seen a pelican? I haven't, but I know that pelicans are naturally generous. They have a generosity nature, and they give in many ways. One, a pelican gives honor. A pelican greets its wife or mate with a sweeping bow. The pelican gives honor to its wife or mate by giving a gracious, gentle, sweeping bow. The pelican is a generous, gentle bird. 2. The pelican gives shelter. The pelican spreads its wings and casts a shadow over its nest. By doing so, it builds a feathered roof over the nest to provide shelter for its family. The pelican has to withstand the heat of the sun to provide shelter for the family. 3. The pelican gives its food even to its enemies. The pelican catches fish by diving into the water. With its mouth, it scoops up the fishes along with the water into its pouch. Before it can swallow the fishes, it has to drain the water from the pouch. In this time, the passing seagulls will take advantage and steal some fishes out of the pelican's mouth. When this happens, the pelican does not attack the seagulls, but instead continue to catch more fishes. See how generous the pelican is. Today, we will take a look into the word generosity. What is generosity? The Cambridge Dictionary defines generosity as a willingness to give help and support. Out of the usual, more than the usual, more than expected. Giving help and support includes giving money, giving food, giving of our time, our talent, and our energy. This is the basic meaning of generosity. The opposite of generosity is stinginess. A stingy person is not willing to give. Instead, he clings on to what he has and say, "It's mine, 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 don't you dare to touch." Well, there's a bigger picture of generosity in God's dictionary. God wants us to know that what we have belongs to Him, and He has a purpose for what we have. Therefore, generosity is giving to others and also giving to God to fulfill God's purposes for our lives. God wants us to provide for the poor and the needy and the hungry. God also wants us to use our money, our talent, our time, our energy to spread the gospel. What does the Bible say about generosity? Let's proceed to Bible story to learn more.
Good afternoon, children. This is Auntie Mao Ching here. Today, I would like to tell you a story entitled The Poor Widow's Offering. Children, have you ever thought how did people in Jesus' time give their offering? You see, during Jesus' time, people would bring their offering to the temple and they would drop it into collection boxes. These collection boxes would be kept inside the temple. One day, Jesus went to the temple with his disciples. He sat in the corner and observed how people gave their offering. Some of these rich people in Jerusalem, they will come. They live in nice houses and wore fancy clothes. They have plenty to eat. So when they go to the temple, they will take some of the money they have left over to the temple. Dressed in their finest clothes, they would go to the temple where they knew a lot of people would be there. After looking around to make sure that people notice them dropping the coins, they would make as much noise as possible. and they want people to praise them. Oh, he is very generous. Jesus knew that these people brought only what was left after they have purchased or spent on things that they wanted. They knew they have not given up a single thing. They had not gone hungry. They had not sacrificed. Suddenly, Jesus noticed a woman at the collection box. He knew that this woman is a widow. Her husband had died, and she is very poor. Many a times, she had no food to eat. The woman looked around to see if anyone was watching. She was very embarrassed because she only brought a very tiny offering. How much do you think she brought? Well, she brought only a few coins which she had left in her pocket. She took out the coins and looked around and hurriedly dropped those coins into the collection box. She thought nobody saw her, but Jesus had seen her. He had seen the two tiny coins that she slipped into the offering box. Jesus said to his disciples, "Look, this is indeed a generous giver. This poor widow has put in more than all the others. She has given all that she has, all that she had, all her money." As the widow heard Jesus' words, tears of joy filled her eyes. She had no money to buy bread for dinner, but she was happy to give the offering to God. Even though the offering is tiny, but she gave it cheerfully and out of her love for God. There was another lady. She also brought her offering. This lady is a very rich lady. She had lots of jewelry. She has a lot of ornaments on her hair and beautiful clothes to wear. She's from a rich family. She too went to the temple to give her offering. She took out her purse, looked around and see if anyone was watching her. And out of that purse, which contains a lot of coins, she took only a few pieces and put it into the offering, making sure that everyone saw that she gave the offering. Well, children, you have watched these two ladies. One is a poor widow without any money and always starving and in hunger. Whereas the other lady, she has more than enough with her beautiful jewelry and plenty of coins in her pocket. Who do you think gave the most? Well, from the story, we have learned, Jesus said that the poor widow, even though she gave tiny coins, but she gave more than the rest. She gave out of her love for God, out of the little that she has. She gave generously to God. How many of us would be like this poor widow? Are we willing to give all that we have, out of what we have left? Who is the generous one? You are right, children. The poor widow is the generous one. When we think, God is not seeing. God knows all. God loves a cheerful giver. So let us give cheerfully. Generosity shows an outflow of our love for our God. Let us give out of our heart, not left over to our God. And God surely see, and God knows, and God will reward those who give generously and out of their heart. I hope, children, you have enjoyed our Bible story today. See you.
Hi, children. It's craft time. Today, we are going to make the pelican pouch. The pouch of the pelican dangles down from the beak. And the pelican uses the pouch to catch many fishes or its food. And that's where it feeds the babies. Okay? First, you trace or draw two pelicans. Two same pelicans on a manila cardboard. The manila cardboard is harder, okay? It's thicker. Then you cut out the two pelicans. Okay? Then you start coloring one. You can use color pencils or crayon or whatever. That, you know, pelicans are very colorful, so you can color whatever color you like, okay? Then you get like that. This is the colored pelican, okay? Only color one is enough already. Then the other pelican you put behind, okay? Stick together. Then you use the glue to stick the two pelicans together. You put the glue on the body except the head and the neck area. The head a little bit. And this neck area, do not put glue yet. Okay, but the body here, all you can glue already. Then you get a balloon. Okay, blow it. Not too big, Twist it, and then tie with a rubber band. Then insert into the in between the neck here. Can you see? Then adjust it. And then you can use a staple to staple the neck here. So this is the pouch, the pelicans pouch. Okay, children, enjoy your craft. Goodbye.
Good afternoon, children. I'm teacher Huining. Welcome back to KKC Online. Today's lesson is on generosity versus stinginess. Let us learn about the memory verse today. It is from 2 Corinthians chapter 9 verse 6. CEV version. The words for today is, a few seeds make a small harvest, but a lot of seeds make a big harvest. Let us go through the words again. A few seeds make a small harvest, but a lot of seeds make a big harvest. Children, as you know, if we put a few seeds on the ground, you will only harvest a few plants. Similarly, if we put a lot of seeds on the ground, you will get many, many plants that produce plentiful fruits for you. So the few seeds with small harvest is representing stinginess. A lot of seeds with big harvest represents the generosity of our heart. Look at the slide. There are some missing words from it. Can you fill it up and send to Teacher Kim or Teacher Huiling to check on it to get your points? I'm sure you can, children. You'll do well. Thank you. See you next week, children. Bye-bye.
We have learned so much about generosity today. Can you tell me what form of a giving pleases God? The amount we give or the condition of our hearts? Of course, the condition of our hearts and not the amount. One, God says if we are giving out of love, seeking nothing in return. Jesus praised the widow who gave a penny. Though it was a little, but that was all that she had. She gave out of her poverty, but out of love for Jesus, seeking nothing in return. Two, God says if you are giving out of a grateful and thankful heart. Jesus gave us everything. What we have belongs to Him. So be grateful and thankful that we are able to give because He first gave us. Three, God says if we are giving willingly and cheerfully. Be happy to give. Give happily. And not because someone is looking at you. Now, somebody asks, God owns everything. Why does He still want us to give? God wants us to give because He wants us to be blessed. The Bible says, 1. Sow bountifully and you shall reap bountifully. Many seeds make a big harvest. The more you give, the more you receive. 2. It's more blessed to give than to receive. Well, we are giving not because we want to be blessed, but because we love God, who first gave us. God gave us His only Son, Jesus. Another form of generosity is recycling. Recycling? Are you sure? Yes, recycling. Recycling is being generous to our next generation. Don't use up everything, every resources on earth now. Keep them. Recycle. Keep some resources for our next generation. So kids, make your own recycle bins at home. And recycle your old papers, metals, plastics, and glass. You can also start a recycle project in school. So start recycling now and keep some resources for our next generation. Be generous to them. Shall we pray as we end today's lesson? Dear Lord, give me a generous heart, a heart that is willing to give, a heart that is happy to give. In Jesus' name, amen.